在那时候没事。
他以前没有听过。
Heavenly Father, the Creator of the heavens and this earth, the Creator of us, your people is now assembled at the place that you said you will meet us at.
亲爱的天父，天和地的造物主，你创造了我们，你的子民现在聚集在你的殿中。你说过你要在这里与我们相聚。
May your glory shine, and may your mercy come.
愿你的荣耀彰显，愿你的恩，愿你的怜悯临到。
Now let your word be preached, and let your words be heard.
愿你的话语被传扬，愿你的话语被聆听到。
In Jesus' holy name, we pray.
奉耶稣基督圣名求。
Amen. Good morning, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姐妹，大家早上好。
For the last 2 weeks, Pastor Davis had preached about part one and part two about at the feet of Jesus.
在过去两星期内呢，戴牧师呢，戴牧师讲，就在耶稣脚前这个题目讲了第一部分、第二部分。
Today is part three. But before that, let us take some time to review the main points of his teaching.
今天呢我们讲将讲第三部分，但是呢在讲以前呢，我们花一些时间去回顾一下第一部和第二部。
Anybody still remember that?
大家还记得咱们不是讲到的内容吗？
This is very important stuff, please remember.
这些东西非常，这些咱们不是讲的东西非常重要，请大家一定要记住。
Okay, totally 4 points. One,In Luke chapter 7, through 36 to 50, the woman that everyone knows that she's a sinner washed Jesus' feet with ointment and her tears. At that, by that case, we have learned that Jesus, who knows every word about us, love us just the same and wait to forgive our sin.And to cleanse us.
戴牧师讲到一共有四点。第一点呢，就是在路加福音的第七章36到50节，有一个妇人，大家知道是一个罪人，他用香膏的他的眼泪洗耶稣脚。从这几节圣经呢，我们可以学到，耶稣基督知道我们最坏的一面，但是呢，他照样的爱我们，等待的去赦免我们，去洗净我们。
Point two, in Luke chapter 10 through 38 to 42, Mary, the sister of Martha, sit at Jesus' feet. From that case, we learn that Jesus, who wants our service and our work, most of all, wants us.
第二点呢，是在路加福音的第十章38到42节，玛丽就是马大的妹妹，坐在耶稣脚前。从这几节圣经呢，我们可以学到呢，耶稣基督他希望我们去侍奉他，去做他圣工，但是他最想得到的是我们。
Point three, in the book of John, chapter 11:20-40, in the story that Jesus called Lazarus back to life.We have learned that the grace of the Lord is absolutely sufficient for us in our times of trial and sorrow.
第三点呢，是在约翰福音第十一章20节到40节。这个故事呢，是耶稣让拉萨路复活。从这几节圣经呢，我们学到神的恩典在我们的受试探和我们的痛苦当中是足够我们用的。
The last point four.In John chapter 12, verse 1-3, Mary anointed Jesus with the expensive ointment. In that case, we have learned the Lord Jesus is worthy of our all. all that we are and all that we have.
第四点是在约翰福音第十二章的一到三节，玛丽呢，用非常昂贵的香膏去膏耶稣。从这一点上，我们学到呢，我们的主耶稣配得我们的所有，配得我们的全人，配得我们所拥有的一切。
Today we come to the part three of the message at the feet of Jesus.
我们今天呢，是来讲关于在耶稣脚前的系列，讲到第三点。
If we pay attention to what Pastor Davis is teaching, if we pay attention to what truth have been revealed to us, then naturally there will be a desire rising up in us. That is, I want to come to the feet of Jesus.
如果我们特别关注戴姆斯讲道，我们发现我们可以关注戴姆斯从他的讲道中从启示出的真理来，我们会在心里自然而然地生发出一个渴望，就是说我们也想来到耶稣的脚前。
If you do have this desire, then naturally again a question will come up. How? How do I come to the feet of Jesus?
如果你心里真的有这种渴望的话呢，自然而然的你又会产生另外一个问题，就是说我如何能来到耶稣的脚前？
Where are the feet of Jesus nowadays?
在当今这个时候，哪里是耶稣脚前呢？
In heaven? Then how do we do to get to it?
难道耶稣脚前是在天堂吗？但是我们如何去到那里呢？
So first, I have to explain that today,At the feet of Jesus is a form of expression called poetry.
首先呢，我想解释一下呢，当今呢，就是说现在这个时候，我们说在耶稣脚前是一种诗情画意的描写。
Or songs. It is a way to use words to create pictures in minds to provoke.Imagination and emotion.
这也是一种我们有时候诗歌的一种表现形式，就是说通过这种通过这些词汇的表达，让我们在脑海中产生一种想象。另外呢，就是说产生一个图画，另外一个激发出我们的情感。
Let me give an example in Chinese about poetry and songs.
我想给大家一个例子，就是说。用中国的这个诗歌，中国的诗歌和诗歌形式来给大家举一个例子。
There's a person called Wen Tingjun in Tang Dynasty wrote a poem. The second line goes like this. In English, it's very hard to say. Corkscrew and small inn and the moon, footprints, broad bridge and the frost.
这个诗的作者呢是唐代的一个诗人，叫温庭筠。他在这个这一首诗当中第二句呢是这样写的：鸡声茅店月，人迹板桥霜。
Sorry, English speaking brothers and sisters. Sorry. Okay. Okay. These you can see. You can see there are 10 Chinese characters. Every one of them are nouns.No verbs, no adjectives, no adverbs. Nobody speak like that.
在这两句的诗词当中呢，一共有十个字，每个字都是一个名词，没有动词，没有形容词，也没有副词。我想我们大家都不会这样说话。
It's a poetic expression. It magically creates a beautiful, thoughtful picture about how a journey in life.Begin.
这是一个诗意的表达，通过这些字呢，能大家产生一种魔幻般的想象力，这种想象呢，针对一个人在开始的一个旅程前的一个情景。
The crow of the cogs, the moonlight still shining at the hotel's room, but the man has to get up and prepare a long journey ahead.
这个公鸡的叫声呢，这个照在这个客栈房间里这个月光，所有这一切呢，让这个人呢起床，然后准备前面即将到来的很长的一个旅途。
This provoke your imagination and your emotion.
所以这些所有这些呢，都激发出你一种想象和你一种情感。
Same as at the feet of Jesus.
这和在耶稣脚前是一样的。
Today it became a poetic expression. It's a spiritual expression.
今天呢，这种表达就是一种诗意的表达，是一种属灵的一种表达。
Jesus, our Lord, is now in heaven at the right side of God the Father.
我们的主耶稣呢，现在在天堂，在父神的右边。
To be at the feet of Jesus is to be taken up into heaven spiritually.
我们在说在耶稣脚前呢，就是说你在灵里被提到了天堂。
So, in there, Colossians 3:1 have this picture. And in there, Jesus let us go through whatever the previous saints gone through at his feet.
这个图画呢，在格罗多Colossians。格罗西书的13章一节呢，给大家这个图画，在耶稣脚前呢，耶稣让我们经历的所有先前的圣徒所经历过的一切。
Our church used to sing a song, when Pastor Rogers still here. Some of you may remember that. That song is called No Higher Calling.
我们教会曾经在Roger 牧师在的时候呢，我们曾经唱过一个歌，可能有些人还记这歌。这歌就是没有在至高之处。
Anybody remember that? Let's hear about 1 minute of it, okay?
大家还记着有人记得这首歌吗？大家咱听听这歌，咱听一分钟。
Maybe it will wake up some of your memory.
可能它会唤醒你的记忆。
Okay, let's listen to. Please pay attention to the first line of the lyric. First line.
Down at your feet, O Lord, is the Most High place in your breath.Lord, at your feet, O Lord.
Beautiful picture. Can you have that picture in your
presence, Lord? We seek your face. We seek your face. There is no.
Okay, now I hope to give you the picture, the poetic picture. Down at your feet, O Lord, is the most high place.
我想呢，你们现在脑海中已经有这种诗情画意的画面了。在耶稣脚前呢，是至高之处。
What about the place that higher than his feet?
但是在他脚以上的地方。是有多高呢？
You see, this is a poetic expression, not a logical, rational expression.
从这点大家可以看到，这就是一种 诗意的表达，在逻辑上呢和在逻辑上不合理，在也大家也觉得不合理。
If you want to come to the feet of Jesus, you need not only your mind, your will, you also need to involve with your imagination, your emotion. Come with your being.
如果你想来到耶稣脚前呢，你不仅要用你的思维，用你的用你的愿望，你需要还用你的想象，你的情感，而把你的全人带到耶稣面前。
Brothers and sisters, love your God with all your hearts, all your souls, all your minds, and all your strength.
弟兄姐妹们，你们要尽心、尽性、尽意、尽力爱主你的神。
So for part three of At the Feet of Jesus, let us look at it from another perspective, the poetic perspective.
在这第三部分，在耶稣脚前这第三部分呢，我们从另外一个角度呢来看一看这个这一点。
I want to provide three pictures to help to provoke your imagination and your emotion.
我们用一种诗意的角度来看待这个问题。我们呢我想用我们的想象力和我们的情感来看这个问题。
May the Holy Spirit lead you to the feet of Jesus at your devotion time.
在你灵修的时候呢，愿圣灵呢把你带到耶稣的脚前。
The three pictures are, first at the feet of Jesus while he was teaching and healing.
这三个画面呢，第一个画面就是说，当你来到耶稣脚前呢，耶稣在教导和医治。
The second picture is at the feet of Jesus when he was crucified.
第二个画面呢，就是当耶稣被钉的时候。
The third picture is at the feet of Jesus after he was resurrected.
在耶稣脚前第三个画面就是说当耶稣复活的时候。
Let's look at the first picture. At the feet of Jesus while he was teaching and healing.
来现在我们解释一下第一个画面，就是说在耶稣脚前呢，当耶稣在教导和医治的时候。
At the feet of Jesus, that's a place, to listen.
在耶稣脚前呢，耶稣脚前是一个聆听的地方。
Are you a Christian? Are you safe? If you are, then come.
你是一个基督徒吗？你得救了吗？如果你是的话，请来到耶稣脚前。
Remember the man in Gerasenes who was possessed by the demon called Legion. Remember that?
大家知道在格拉森的一个男人被一群叫群的魔鬼附身的故事吗？
Jesus cast out the demons and about 2,000 pigs drowned.
耶稣呢赶出了那个人上附在那个人上的鬼，然后呢有2000头猪被淹死了。
The man was saved. He became a Christian.
这个男人呢得救了，而且他成了一个基督徒。
After that, what did he do?
在那以后他做了什么呢？
With clothes on him and with a right mind, he was sitting at the feet of Jesus.
在那以后呢，他就穿着衣服，心里明白过来，坐在耶稣的脚前。
The book of Luke, chapter 8, verse 35. Then they went out to see what was done and came to Jesus and found the man.Out of whom the devils were departed, sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid.
在路加福音第八章三十五节，众人出来要看是什么事，到了耶稣那里，看见鬼所离开的那人坐在耶稣脚前，穿着衣服，心里明白过来，他们就害怕。
Usually, when Jesus teaches, the first thing he will do is sit down.
通常呢，在耶稣教导时候呢，第一件事儿他 他就要坐下来。
I know that today's practice is opposite to the ancient times. The teacher stands now while the student sit down today.
我想当今的现在呢，和古时候正好是反过来的。当老师教导的时候呢，学生是坐下，老师是站的。
You can look at Matthew chapter 5 verse 1.Picture a big crowd that is trying to listen to Jesus.
这一点你可以在马太福音的第五章第一节你可以看到。这个画面就是说一大群人在去聆听耶稣讲道。
So everybody is trying to come closer and hear him clearly.So the one who gets to the closest point to Jesus almost need to lay down at his feet because all other people, they also need to see and hear Jesus. Got the picture?
所有呢这些人呢都试图呢离耶稣更近一点，然后呢这样就听得更清楚点。所以呢离耶稣最近的地方呢那些人呢他需要坐下来，因为后面的人需要去听到看到耶稣。大家脑里能想象出这幅画面来吗？
At the feet of Jesus is the place that you can hear him most clearly.
在耶稣脚前是一个地方，在那个地方呢你听耶稣讲道听得最清楚。
And there have you heard him saying, Bless are the poor in spirit.For theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
在那里你听到耶稣在讲，哀恸的人有福了，因为他们必得安慰。
And there, can you, please, the next verses? The next verse. At the feet of Jesus, have you heard him saying,Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
在耶稣脚前，你听到耶稣在说：“清心的人有福了，因为他们必得见神。”
Have you hear him saying, "Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on hill on a hill cannot be hid."
在那里，你们是否听到耶稣在说：“你们是世上的光。”城造在山上是不能隐藏的。
Or, at there, have you hear him saying that, and if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out and cast it from thee, for it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell.
在那里你是否听到耶稣在说，若你的右眼叫你跌倒，就弯出来丢掉，宁可失去白体中的一体，不可叫全身丢在地狱里。
At the feet of Jesus, have you hear him saying, Take therefore no thought for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself.Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof.
在耶稣脚前，你是否听到耶稣在说，不要为明天忧虑，因为明天自有明天的忧虑，一天的忧虑，一天难处一天当就好了。
If you have heard of him, you will be astonished at his doctrine.
如果你听到这些的话，你会稀奇他的教训。
Because what he was saying is not like what Aldo is saying.
因为耶稣教导不像阿斗的教导。
Aldo will say, if you do this, God may like you. If you do that, God may not like it. Why is Aldo talking like this? Because Aldo is not God. He cannot say things for God.
阿斗会说如果你做这些事儿呢，上帝会喜欢你；如果你做那些事儿，上帝会不喜欢你。为什么阿斗会这样说呢？因为阿斗不是上帝， 阿斗不能替上帝说话。
But Jesus is different. He taught them as one having authority. He can say things for God with assurance because he is the Son of God.
但是耶稣不一样，他能带着权柄说话，他能非常肯定的说话，因为他就是上帝的儿子，他就是上帝。
Come to his feet and listen.
大家来到耶稣脚前去聆听。
Some people come to the feet of Jesus and listen, but others, they listen and then come to the feet of Jesus.
一些人呢，来到耶稣脚前去聆听，另外一些人呢，听到了耶稣的讲道，然后就来到耶稣的脚前。
Many of them heard and believed that Jesus was the Messiah, so they brought their patients to the feet of Jesus, and they got healed.
许多人都听说呢，耶稣是救世主，所以呢，他们把病人带到了耶稣的脚前，然后这病人就得医治了。
Remember Jairus, a ruler of the synagogue. He heard of Jesus, and then he came to his feet and begged him to save his daughter. Then his daughter came back to life.
大家记得一个叫雅鲁的管会堂的人吗？他听到了耶稣，然后来到耶稣面前，让耶稣去救他女儿，然后呢，他的女儿就复活了。
And even a Gentile woman heard of Jesus and then come to his feet. Then her daughter was saved.
甚至一个外邦的女子呢，来到耶稣脚前呢，她的女儿就得救了。
Come, brothers and sisters. Either you come to his feet and listen, or listen and come to his feet and plead with him.
来吧，弟兄姐妹们，来到耶稣脚前去聆听，或者当你听到了耶稣的话语，就来到他脚前向他祈求。
And then another picture, at the feet of Jesus, it can be a place to listen, and also it can be a place to observe.
第二个画面呢，当你来到耶稣脚前呢，来到耶稣脚前是一个聆听的地方。但是呢，也是你观察的一地。
And he, the innocent Son of God and Son of Man, was crucified on the cross. The blood came out from his broken body, running down to his feet, dropping down from his feet to the ground.
耶稣呢，上帝的女儿，上帝的独生子，一个毫无瑕疵。无罪的人被钉在十字架上，他的血在他破碎的身体当中流出来，顺着他的脚流到了地上。
Whoever that stayed at the feet of Jesus at that time will observe that they are covered with his blood.
那些来到耶稣脚前的那些人呢，他们会观察到这个耶稣的宝血遮盖了他们。
Who will stay at the feet of Jesus at that time?
那个时候谁在耶稣脚前呢？
Who will stay at the feet of Jesus on the cross?
Okay. 那是谁会来到耶稣的脚前呢？
The one...Who has truly repented?
那些是那些真正悔改的人。
Let me explain.
我解释一下。
There are two kinds of repentance.
有两种悔改。
One is genuine repentance involves a godly sorrow for having offended God.
一种呢是真正的悔改，这种悔改是因为因着得罪了上帝呢，从心里有一种属灵的忧伤痛苦。
And the other one is motivated simply by a desire to escape paying the cost for one's sin.
第二种呢， 第二种悔改呢，它是基于只是想逃离这个因为犯罪所付出这种代价，所要去悔改。
Those who have been parents, you will know, right? When I catch my son watching video before finishing his homework, he will say what? Daddy, I am sorry. I'm so sorry. Please don't spank me.
我想家长们都可有这个都有这种经历。当我的儿子呢，当我发现他去在玩电脑游戏而没有去写作业的话呢，我发现以后他就会到我面前说，哦，对不起，爸爸对不起，实在是对不起。
What kind of repentance is this? This repentance is born out of fear of punishment or the consequence.
他这样做呢，实际他怕挨打。他为什么悔改呢？因为他怕挨打。
Also, as fallen human beings, we have this mysterious, astonishing ability to rationalize our sin, to explain our sin to ourselves, to stop the accusing voice of our own conscience.
对于我们堕落的人来讲呢，我们内心有一种神秘的、让人吃惊的一种能力。这种能力呢，能让我们把我们的犯罪呢合理化，从而呢消除我们良心里那种谴责的声音。
I am sorry, but
上帝对不起，但是呢
，Lord, you have to understand that this was not a good day. I have things on my mind. I was under a lot of pressure, and so on.
主啊，你应该理解，今天是我很坏的一天，我脑子很乱，而且呢，我有很多在我身上有很多压力，等等等等。
The Holy Spirit has to work in our hearts to awaken us out of our deep slumber to experience the guilt.
圣灵呢会在我们心里做工，让我们呢从感知罪的这种休眠状态下呢清醒过来。
I think everyone remember the story of David and Bathsheba, right?
我想大家都记得大卫和拔示巴的故事吧。
David did whatever he thought that he needed to do.
大卫呢做了他觉得他需要做的事情。
Prophet Nathan was sent to David and tell him a parable. Remember?
大家记得先知拿单呢来到大卫面前呢给他讲了一个预言。
King David was furious about the injustice and atrocity in the story.
大卫听了那个预言那故事以后呢是暴怒，而且呢觉得那个人太不公平了。
Then Nathan confronted him and say, Second Samuel chapter 12 verse 7, and Nathan said to David, thou art the man.
然后呢拿单就直面大卫，在这个撒母耳记下呢，拿单对大卫说：“你就是那人。”
Then what happened?
接下来发生了什么呢
？Let us read Psalm 51.
我们来读诗篇第五十一篇。
After that, David wrote this. He says. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercy. Blot out my transgressions.
那件事以后呢，大卫写下这个诗篇。这诗篇这一开始写到，神啊，求你按你的慈爱怜悯我，按你丰盛的慈悲涂抹我的过犯。
Wash me.Thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin.
求你将我的罪孽洗除净尽，并洁除我的罪。
For I acknowledge my transgression and my sin is ever before me.
因为我知道我的过犯，我的罪常在我面前。
After being awakened, by the prophetic insight, after being revealed by the heavenly light, after being convicted by the Holy Spirit, my dead conscience revived.
经过这个先知的引导，也经过圣灵的启示，也经过上帝的圣灵的审判呢，我的良知被复活了。
Wherever I turn, my sin is ever before me. I cannot stand it. I need to be washed clean.
当我转身呢，我发现我的罪常在我面前，我的罪需要被洗净。
Now, this is the beginning of true repentance.
现在呢，大家可以知道这些就是真正的悔改的开始。
And only this kind of person will stay at the feet of Jesus on the cross.
只有这类人会待在耶稣的脚前。
And only this kind of person will observe the agony of Jesus and experience the mercy of God. And here he said, it is finished.
只有这种人呢，能真正去观察在十字架上的耶稣的痛苦，去体会他的怜悯，然后呢，去听耶稣说，成了。
Psalms 103:11-12. For as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him.
诗篇的第103篇的第11节，天离地何等的高，他的慈爱向敬畏他的人也是何等的大。
As far as the east from the west, so far has he removed our transgression from us.
东离西有多远，他叫我们的过犯离我们也有多远。
Heaven, earth, east, west, brothers and sisters.What is this? A cross.
天、地、东、西，弟兄姐妹，这是什么意思？这就是十字架的画面。
So there's the third picture I want to provide.
现在呢，我想给大家呈现第三幅画面。
At the feet of the resurrected Jesus.
在复活的耶稣的脚面前，脚前。
At the feet of the resurrected Jesus, you will hear him saying something that you and I desperately need to hear today. That is, be not afraid.
在复活的耶稣脚面前呢，你大家可以听到耶稣在对我们，在我们绝望的时候对我们说，不要害怕。
The book of Matthew, chapter 28, verse 9 and 10. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, All hail. And they came and held him by the feet and worshiped him.
在马太福音的第九节和第十节，第九节，忽然耶稣遇见他们，说，愿你们平安。他们就上前抱住他的脚，拜他。
Then said Jesus unto them, Be not afraid. Go tell my brethren that they go to Galilee, and there shall they see me.
然后耶稣对他们说，不要害怕，你们去告诉我的弟兄，叫他们往加利利去，在那里必见我。
Why Jesus tell them, Be not afraid? What are they afraid of?
为什么耶稣对他们说，不要害怕，他们在怕什么呢？
Maybe the Jesus they met is not real. It's a ghost. Oh, I'm afraid of ghosts.
也许呢，他们在想，他们遇到的耶稣呢，不是一个真的耶稣，只是一个鬼。我看见鬼了。
Nah, the scripture says they held him by the feet. He's not a ghost.
但是经文当中说呢，他们抱住了耶稣的脚，所以呢。耶稣不是个鬼。
Maybe they are afraid of seeing an angel or God himself. In their culture, if you see an angel, that means you will die.
或者呢，他们看见的是一个天使，或者看见的是是上帝。在当时他们的文化当中呢，如果你看见天使的话，这就意味着你快死了。
If Jesus appear and show himself today here to us, will you be excited?
如果耶稣呢在今天的这里显现给我们，你们会感到很兴奋吗？
In their culture, that means everybody here will die before you go home.
要按当时以色列的文化他们的文化来说呢，我们今天在座所有人如果看到耶稣的话呢，在我们回家以前都活不了。
Well, we don't have that culture, forget it.
我们没有这种文化，所以呢，大家不要介意。
Or maybe what they are afraid of is they thought the high priest and the Romans had killed Jesus, and they set up rules, regulations, and guidelines.Don't mention this guy's name. Do not preach or practice what he had taught.
如果另外一个他们想到罗马人和大祭司呢，他们杀了耶稣，而是定了很多条条规范，让人们不要去传扬这个人所讲的东西。如果这样去做的话，你会死。
Otherwise, they will punish or even kill any follower of Jesus.If they don't obey them.
如果呢你不这样做的话呢，如果你不顺服他们的话呢，他们会惩罚你，甚至杀了你。
The fear dominates their hearts. Now Jesus is resurrected. But this glorious resurrected Jesus, however, didn't take out any of their oppressors or show his power to any of their enemies. So,What is he up to? Will we be saved?
耶稣呢？这恐惧呢占据他们心。耶稣呢，当时并没有把罗马的势力，把那黑暗势力带走。所以呢，他们会想：耶稣会做什么？耶稣会让我们安全吗
？There's fear there.
这恐惧还是在那里。
Today.The COVID-19 virus has been made into a god.
今天呢，新冠病毒已经变成了一个上帝。
This fearful god with little g, okay? This fearful god is giving laws, commandments, statutes, ordinances to his occupied territory.
这个。上帝，当然这上帝是一个小写上是这个上帝，所以呢这个上帝呢在他统治的范围内呢制定了律法，制定了诫命、典章和律例。
People need to obey these laws or they will be infected, they will be put into jail, they will be enslaved.
人们呢需要遵循这些法律，不然的话呢他们就会感染病毒，他们就会被送进监狱，他们就会被奴役。
And this God is waging his holy war or unholy war to the whole world now.
这个上帝呢，现在已经在向全世界发动了一场圣战。
The fear dominates many people's heart. Now our God, the God who is the creator of all,is supposed to have power in the realm of microorganisms. But it seems like he didn't do anything. What is he up to? Will we be saved?
现在这种恐惧呢占据了人们的心。我们的上帝呢是创造万有的上帝。他应该有这个能力去控制这种微生物，去在这种微生物肆虐的领域呢去控制它。但是呢现在看起来他什么也没做，他会做什么呢？我们会是安全的吗？
Fear is somewhere here.
我们现在这里就存在着恐惧。
Fear is an interesting thing. Among all the human emotions, fear has the strongest ability to change a person's behavior.
恐惧呢是一个非常有趣的事情。在所有人类情感当中呢，恐惧是最能改变人行为的一种情感。
If you carefully observe the movement of the people around you or around the world when they are in fear, you will find a lot of compelling activity.
如果你观察一下你周围的人呢，他们的行为现在有很多反常的行为现在。
However, we are human. We have ways to deal with our fears. We can hide it.By avoiding saying a word about the things we fear. We can deny it by telling ourselves, let's try some better options. We can ignore it by being busy to do some other many things.
不过呢，我们是人，我们有办法对付这恐惧。我们呢，可能有时候隐藏这种恐惧，或者呢，我们因着我们不想说某个词呢去否定这种恐惧，或者呢我们通过让自己非常忙碌呢去忽略这种恐惧。
If you don't want to hide your fear or deny it or ignore it, you really want to get rid of it, then first you need to confess the existence of it.
如果你不想去隐藏、去否定、去忽略这种恐惧呢，你想去真正的去对付这种恐惧呢，首先要做的，你要承认这种恐惧。
Let me give an example. Matthew 9:12. But when Jesus heard that, he said unto them, "They that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick, and."
我想给大家一个例子，这个例子呢，我们可以从马太福音的9:12可以看到，耶稣听见就说，康健的人用不着医生，有病的人才用得着。
You need to confess that you are sick before you get healed by a doctor.
你在得到医生的医治以前呢，你必须承认，你跟医生承认呢，你有病。
And the second step is you need to trust the one who can and will help you.
第二点就是说你需要去信靠那些信靠那个能医治你的人。
So step one, confess it. Step two, trust the one who has the ability to get rid of it.
第一点承认你有病。第二点去信靠那些能够医治你的人。
Two steps.To get rid of your fear, confess and trust.
两点能去除掉你的恐惧。第一个承认，第二个信靠。
That is actually what confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart means. It is very similar to how you get saved by Jesus.
这一点呢很我们可以理解是承认有病，就是承认，就是说嘴里承认，但是呢，信靠就是相信，心里相信，这个过程呢，很类似于我们得救的过程。
Brothers and sisters, please listen to what God says to us. The book of Isaiah, chapter 41, verse 10.
弟兄姐妹，让我们仔细去聆听上帝是如何对我们讲的。以赛亚书41:10。
Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness.
你不要害怕，因为我与你同在。不要惊慌，因为我是你的神。我必坚固你， 我必帮助你，我必用我公义的右手扶持你。
At the feet of the resurrected Jesus, the disciples remember what he had said before his resurrection.
在复活的耶稣脚前呢，他的门徒呢，记得耶稣在上十字架前对他们所说。
What did he say in John chapter 14, verse 26 to 27?
耶稣说了什么呢？在约翰福音第十四章二十六节。
But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you.
但保惠师就是父因我的名所要差来的圣灵，他要将一切的事指教我们，并且要叫你们想起我来，想起我对你们所说的一切话。
Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you, not as the world gives. Give I unto you, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid.
第二十七节，我留下平安给你们。我将我的平安赐给你们，我所赐的平，我所赐的不像世人所赐的。你们心里不要忧愁，也不要胆怯。
Can you see people's fear? Can you see your own fear? Let's come to the feet of the resurrected Jesus and hear him say, "Be not afraid."
你们感受得到人们的恐惧吗？你们能看到你们自己的恐惧吗？如果是的话呢，让我们来到耶稣复活的耶稣脚前，然后听耶稣说不要害怕。
You see, at the feet of Jesus, it can be a place to listen, it can be a place to observe, and it also can be a place to change.
你们可以发现呢，在耶稣脚前，耶稣脚前是一个聆听的地方，是一个观察的地方，也是一个让人改变的地方。
Everybody sang the song, right? Let the weak say I am strong, let the poor say I am rich, and let the frightened said I am not afraid because of what the Lord has done for us.
大家都唱过这首歌。软弱者已得刚强，贫穷者已得富足，让我们呢就让受惊吓人不再害怕，都因为主已成就了大事。
大事，我们的。So this is the end of my sermon. Pastor had told me to give invitation, but today,I want to invite him to say something about the conclusion of this series that started by him.
这就是我今天讲到的结尾。戴牧师让我去做呼召，但是呢，我还想让戴牧师上来，因为他需要有些事情要宣布一下。
Let's invite Pastor Davis to conclude this series.Maybe next time I will do the invitation.
让我们请戴牧师上来了，对我的讲道做一个总结。下一次我可能去戴牧师去代替戴牧师做呼召。
This series has been a blessing to me.
这个讲道对我来讲也是一个祝福。
The messages have first spoke to me, and then I hope they have spoken to you also.
这些信息呢，对我的心说了话。我想呢，我也希望对你们在座各位的心说话。
The Bible says that every one of us, even those that do not believe in Christ, one day will kneel at His feet.
圣经里说呢， 我们这些信徒，甚至说不信的人，有一天都会来到耶稣的脚前。
The judgment day, all will bow before him.
在大审判的日子呢，我们所有人都要经历这个大审判。
We should be thankful if you're saved that when you bow, you'll be bowing before your Savior. When they bow, they're bowing before their judge.
啊，我们非常感恩，当我们去俯下身了，我们是在我们救主面前俯下身，而那些不信的人呢，是在他们的审判官面前俯下身。
These are serious messages with great truths that we need to continually think about.
这个系列讲道所传递的信息呢，是非常棒的信息，我们呢需要常常思想。
Let's bow our heads.
我们低头。
Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for your grace. 天父，我们感谢你，为了你的恩典，我们感谢你。We thank you for your love. 为了你的爱，我们也感谢你。We thank you, Lord, that you love us enough to pay our sin debt through your Son, Jesus Christ. 我们感谢你的爱，我们到底到为什么程度，到你可以派你自己的独生子为我们的罪钉十字架。Father, I pray that everyone here will think, have I knelt at Jesus' feet and received him as my Savior? 我盼望所来的每一位能够问自己，我有没有马上跪在耶稣的面前，接受他做我个人的主。I pray that every Christian here examine their heart and see, am I being obedient to the one who gave his all for me? 我盼望每一个基督徒能够坚强自己的心，能够问自己，我有没有负我应该负的责任？因为耶稣他负他的责任，他给我们一切，他的生命为了我们。Father, I pray that you will speak to hearts today. 我求你今天在人的心里动工。I pray that all of us will be drawn closer to you because of your love. 我盼望因为你的爱，我们都能够抓到你的面前。That we will humble ourselves and 我们会谦卑在你的面前。We will worship you. 我们会敬拜赞美你。Father, we pray today.That you will bless. 求你祝福今天的呼召。In Jesus' name I pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求。
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you for allowing us to come before you. 天父感谢你，你眷我们到你的面前来。We are sinners. 我们都有罪。But you will wash our sins away in Jesus' blood. 感谢你能够把我们的罪洗净，这是你用耶稣自己的宝血洗净它。Father, I pray today we will rethink this message as we leave. Help it to change our lives because at the feet of Jesus is a place of change. 我盼望今天我们会在世上这几个礼拜的心情我们会来到耶稣的脚前，因为在那个地方，他的脚前是一个改变的地方，改变我们的错，改变我们的想法。Help us, Lord, to do your will. 帮助我们做到你完美的旨意。In Jesus' name we pray. 奉耶稣基督的名求。
Amen.